Hello guys, welcome to Code Decode. In the last video we have covered the workspace setup in Java. In this video we will get started with the variables in Java. So what is variable? A variable is a name given to a memory location and it is basically the unit of storage in a program. The value stored in a variable can be changed during the program execution and we have to declare all the variable before its usage. So there are basically three types of variable, that is local variable, instance variable and static variable. So let's get started. So let's understand all this variable one by one. So let's get started with local variable first. What is local variable? So local variable is basically the variable which is defined inside a method or block or constructor, and its scope starts when we will enter the method and its scope will end when we end that method. So let's understand local variable, what exactly local variable is, with the help of example. So we have STS ID open here and we will create one class. So let's click on new class and let's give the name of class marks. Also check on public static void main because we need that. So here we have class marks. So let's create one method, get marks, or let's say that let's name that get marks. So public void get marks. So let's declare some subjects, or let's declare some marks of the subject. So int max, that is 40. I know that's not a good mark, but okay. Int physics, let's say 80. Int biology, let's say 99. Yeah, good and bad. So okay, so let's try to print this mark outside of that method, because as I have already told you that the scope of local variable exists within the method. So what happens if we'll print that variable outside of that method? So let's print that system.out.print. So if you will try to print this method, it will give you an error. And the error will be max cannot be resolved to a variable. Why? Because its scope will remain inside the get marks method. Okay, so we will cut this method and we will cut this line of code and we will paste it here. So let's print the total of all three. So max plus physics plus biology, and if we have to print this all three marks, we have to create the object of marks and we have to call this get marks method. So let's do that. So marks m is equal to new marks m dot get marks. Let's save it and let's run the code. Okay, so here we have the total marks, that is 219. So this is how local variable works. Okay, so let's move to instance variable. So what is instance variable? Instance variable are non-static variable and are declared in a class outside of any method, constructor or block. So instance variable are declared in a class, but that is declared outside of method, constructor or block. So unlike local variable, we may use access specifier for instance variable like public, private, or if we do not specify any kind of access specifier, then the default access specifier will be used. Initialization of instance variable is not mandatory and its default variable is kind of zero in case of integer. An instance variable can be accessed only by creating objects. So this is the very important point. So let's understand instance variable more with the help of example. So let's create one more class. Let's click on new class. What should we name them? Let's say fruits. Public static void main finish. Okay. So let's create one more class here and name them exotic fruit. Let's declare some variables, that is int dragon fruit, let's say we need 2, int integer kiwi, let's say we need 5. Okay. So here you can see we don't use any kind of method, we don't use any kind of constructor. So this all two variables are declared inside a class but outside of any method or constructor. So let's use them. So let's create the object of exotic fruit class. So ef equal to new now you can change the value of this dragon fruit and kiwi for each new object, because whenever you will like create one object, you will get one copy of these two variables. So if you will modify this, so dragon fruit is equal to 7. So if you will print this system dot sys dot out dot print, if you will you will see it will print 7. See, and if we'll again print system, let's copy this. Kiwi. Oh, sorry, I forgot to mention line breaker. So ln is basically used to move the cursor into the next line. So here it is. Now let's modify ef dot kiwi is equal to 8, and now print again. And now see what happened. Oh, again I forgot to put ln here, that is the next line. So here it is, 7, 5 and 8. Okay, so let's create one more object of this exotic fruit class and I'll name them ef1, ef new, you can say. Let's print this kiwi and dragon fruit one more time. Yes, new dot dragon fruit control F control S. Let's see. So now you can see we have modified the value of dragon fruit using ef.dragonfruits, and we modified value 7, so it will first print 7. Then we haven't modified the value of kiwi, so it printed 5. Then we again modified the value of kiwi as 8, then it printed 8. Now we created a new object that is ef new, and we haven't modified any of the value of dragon or kiwis, so it print 2 and 5. So this is all how this is how instance variable work. So as of now, we have discussed about local variable and instance variable. That's it for this video. In the next video, I'll be discussing about static variables, method and block. So till then, keep watching. Good decode. Bye bye.